Welcome back to
GDPG. We're back.
Very sudden. We're playing more Frog Fraction.
Yeah.
I'm hopefully going to beat it this episode.
Hopefully. We're kind of in this weird part.
So, we're in the engine room. Nearly every surface in this room, which is nearly covered with stinky pink goo, which seems to be thicker near a gray machine sitting in the corner. So, presumably, that gray machine is producing the goop.
Yeah, we're going to collect the goop.
So, we're going to collect the goop. The goop is stuck to the surface.
Great,
so, we need something to remove it from the surfaces.
So, remove goop.
I don't know if that'll work.
Dang.
Yeah. A hole in the wall exposes a nest of wires. There's a hatch leading back to the captain's quarters to the fore. So that's where we came from. So
two wires, maybe? Or is the wires where we came from?
I think it's look wires is what you want.
Yeah, that's
or
right.
Or look hole.
Look
either.
Go look wires. Peering into the exposed machinery, you see it looks like an empty coffee can that you're guessing doesn't belong there.
Take coffee.
Can?
Yeah, take can.
You twist the can and it eventually comes loose, but you've ripped the insulation off an adjacent wire in the process, and it begins sparking as it comes in contact with an adjacent strut. You glance at what you've taken. Huh. It really is a coffee can. What next?
Collect goop.
Yeah. Oh, not cofflect. Collect goop. The goop is stuck to the surface.
Use can on goop?
Use can on goop.
Doesn't go there. Go to machine. Just type look again.
Look. Nearly every surface, so a hole
sitting in the corner. Use can on machine?
Use can? You have to be more specific as to what you can
use,
do
use
with
can
it.
On machine.
I was going to try to see
fair.
Can. I've never really played a text-based game before.
There you go.
You place the can below the spigot.
Turn
what next?
Spigot.
Turn, yeah, exactly. I was about to do the same thing. So wait, this is clearly a...
It's not clear how to get the spigot to work. Work spigot?
Works.
I'm wondering if this is a play on words.
I don't understand that verb.
Would we try turn spigot? Maybe twist spigot?
Twist spigot. It's not clear how to get the spigot to work.
Pull spigot?
Pull spigot.
Push spigot.
I don't think spigots get pushed.
I don't think they do either. Look spigot.
Oh yeah, I guess that's a. The machine consists of a spigot aimed at a flat platform. There's an empty coffee can sitting under the spigot. A hammer and sheet of paper has been hastily taped over the base of the platform.
Remove tape.
Oh, I was.
Or take tape.
Let's go ahead and remove tape. You rip the tape off the machine. The note comes with it, revealing a control panel.
Oh, use control panel.
Yeah. You'll have to be more specific.
Look control panel? Yeah.
God. Oh my god. Nope.
It might work with just look control.
Yeah. Most of the control panel is rendered unusable by the sticky pink goop. You see a row of what looks like radio preset buttons, all but two of which are stuck. There's also a big red lever. None of these are legibly labeled.
Pull big red lever?
Yeah, right.
Or pull lever, I guess. Pull the lever!
Pull the lever. Oh my god. Dispensing mom's specialty. The machine says a thick stream of pink goop streams out of it, mostly gets everywhere, but the coffee can does end up filled. You grab the can, a few more drops land in your mouth, and you recognize the flavor. Bacon milkshake.
Nice.
Nice. Atmospheric anomaly detected. Different voice says, a whirring sound ensues, and the bulk of the goop is sucked into invisible vents, leaving just enough goop floating around to be purified.
To be gross and annoying.
Atmosphere purified, the voice says triumphantly. What next?
So we didn't get the goop. Maybe...
It's in the can, though.
Well, is it?
Yeah.
The goop is sucked into invisible vents, leaving just enough goop floating around. So it's not in the can anymore. Maybe turn the... What do they call them? The radio dial?
Press button.
Press button?
I wouldn't call them buttons. They're like button presets. The raise button clicks into place, and the previous selected button pops up. Local currency, says a robotic voice. Yes. I don't understand that verb.
Insert currency?
Insert currency. I don't understand that verb.
Maybe pull lever again? Yeti?
The machine war is dispensing local... Oh, well, the machine war is dispensing local currency. A voice says a thick stream of Zork mids shoot out of the...
Oh, no! Closet,
bounce out the flat platform and scatter around the room. What next? Kill... Zork mids? You can't just go breaking things out of a spaceship. You'll punch a hole in the hull. What next?
Maybe push button again?
Push other... button. Aren't there two buttons?
I would say push button.
The raised...
So it just toggles between those two.
What next?
Maybe now.
Pull lever.
Yeah.
Dispensing my specialty, more pink coop streams out, splashing against the flat platform and basically everywhere. Atmosphere not detected. The vents...
Oh, so maybe you do have it. Look, can. Oh, it is still in there. Goop.
What okay. next?
I don't know. Use can on wires?
Use can on... Use can on
you
wires.
You spelled can wrong.
Can. That doesn't go there.
Use goop on wires?
Use goop on wires. That doesn't go there.
Maybe go back up.
Go... back up.
I would just say go ladder. Go ladder. Up ladder. Or use ladder. Why?
I don't understand that very much.
Oh, maybe. Wait, look again. I think maybe there's no ladder here. Maybe we just have to go through.
Look.
A hole in the wall. Exposes wires. There's a hatch leading back to the cabin. Okay, so go hatch.
Cabin's quarters.
Oh, this is a fun tidbit. Blobs of sticky pink goop and unaccountable Zorkmids drift around the room, just like back in the dorms.
What next? So where?
Up ladder?
Yeah, let's go up. I feel like we're missing something, though, in that last area.
Go ladder? Okay, maybe now we use the goop on the control deck.
Oh, yeah.
Or on the... Yeah.
So, control...
No, use goop on...
Use goop...
Control.
Control. That doesn't go there.
Use can on control?
Can on... I probably have to...
Yeah. Can't skip it, man.
Use can on control. It doesn't go there. Control.
Look control.
The control deck consists of an array of switches and a pair of joysticks. Let's hope you never need to override the ship's autopilot because they're definitely not frog joysticks. Override autopilot. That's how to fill out the controls.
Maybe there is still something down there. I mean, like, maybe we could use the wires on the Zork mids.
So... down ladder.
Go hatch.
Go hatch.
Use wires.
Wires. You have to be more specific.
Okay, so maybe use wires on Zork mid.
Use wires on Zork mid. That doesn't go there. So let's go back to the wires.
Look wires.
Look wires. It's a bare wire in there sparking as it makes contact with adjacent strut. What next? Goop strut?
Good strut?
Oh. Whoops.
Use goop on strut?
Yeah.
You have to write use so it knows what you're trying to do.
Strut. It doesn't go there.
I tell you what.
I don't know,
Let's pause until we figure this out.
Yeah.
Okay, so we found a nightstand that has a thick manual, so I guess read manual?
Yeah, read manual? It's a manual for the
navigation. There you go. You feel confident understanding how to use the interface well enough to set up a route back to Bugmars. And we got 2.5 eighth points.
Two and an eighth points.
So I would go up ladder or go ladder.
Yeah, go ladder.
And then...
And then what? Control deck? A glowing display.
Use control?
Yeah. Use control? You have to be more specific.
Look control?
What do you want to do with the controls?
Change route.
Change route.
There you go.
Screen spills forth a slew of steps. I just passed by.
Try use or look control.
The control deck consists of an array of... Oh, maybe we should go back to the display.
Yeah, maybe that is what it is. Look display.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll do that. A glowing green display shows a map of the galaxy's destination you don't recognize. Marked in an ETA of about 3,000 years. Looking closer, you see two on-screen buttons.
Oh,
labeled.
Okay. Now we do new destination.
Yes. New destination. You definitely pop course back to Bugmars.
The engines roar and you feel a G-forces shift.
57 and three-fifths years. You might die. That's to determine that the vast majority of the time is going to be spent going through bug customs. Luckily, you can sleep through most of it. Your score's got by 3 1/3 points. Yes. What next?
Now we can sleep. Yep. So I would go down ladder. And sleep.
Yep. Sleep.
We did it.
Your head has barely touched the pillow when alarm begins repeating. Perfume chamber empty. You'll wake up cranky. You assume it's going to stop eventually, but a couple of minutes later, it still hasn't. You get up, and now there's no way you can sleep like that. What next?
The pillow when the alarm starts repeating. Use perfume chamber empty? What?
Turn off alarm? You can't find the source of the alarm.
Put goop in ears?
Oh, yeah. Put goop in ears.
Damn it.
Put goop in.
Use goop on ears.
Use goop on ears.
No. Use goop on chamber?
Use goop.
What? No, on chamber.
You bring the can close to the hole, and you bring the hole, sucks the pink goop right in, and nearby gauge fills up.
Oh, nice.
By 9 1/2 of a point. What next?
Sleep.
Try to sleep, but you can't. That bare wire loose in the engine room might start a fire.
Oh, man.
What next?
So now we got to go back down there?
So a down hatch?
Go hatch? Yeah.
Go hatch?
Yeah.
All right. The surface room is covered, so look wire. Sparking is kind of a distant strut.
Look can. Do we still have any goop?
It's full of
steam. Oh, it is.
Okay.
Oh,
wait. How about just move wire?
Move wire?
Try to pull the wire away from the nearby components, but it returns to its natural position touching the strut.
Use can on strut?
Use can on strut. It doesn't go there. Place can on strut.
That's...
I know. That doesn't go there.
Maybe we should pause again?
Yeah. Maybe. How about inventory? We haven't looked at our inventory. You're
holding electrical...
Oh, electrical tape!
Motherfucker!
Fucking A, I forgot about that.
Wait.
Fuck.
But we never knew we had that.
No, yes, we did. We got
did
it.
We?
Yeah, I think we got earlier tape wire. You have the wire on the bear insulating it. Your score has gone up by 1 2/3 point. What next? God damn it.
Now we can sleep. Wait, when did we get the electrical tape?
I think we got it when we entered. Oh, my God. Go hatch. Great.
Sleep.
You lie down, sleeping pod, close the lid and drift off, secure that in 57 and something years, you return to Bugmars, a wealthy frog. When you wake up, you're clearly not in your sleep pod. You blearily glance around to get your bearings, and you appear to have been sleeping on a heart-shaped bed covered with roses. A voice comes from the next room. Awake already? A wispy human figure in a bath robe and crown walks in. She bends over and kisses you on the nose, and suddenly you feel your body shifting. Yay! She laughs and claps, and you realize that you've been transformed into a human form.
And on that note, I think that's all for this episode.
What?
So this one was obviously a little weird because we were only in text adventure mode, but actually I think this is the end of text adventure.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure. Anyway.
Yeah, we should absolutely do another episode.
So next episode will definitely be the finale because there isn't a ton left.
Holy crap, man. Text-based adventures. We should ask about that. About the specificity of text-based adventures.
Yeah, I guess... Well, that's the thing, like, they're definitely mimicking the old style of text adventures, right?
Yeah. Which,
those old games did require that kind of level of...
Yeah, they really did.
So, I guess, maybe the question of the day is a two-parter, right? Did they accomplish... Do you think that they were successful in mimicking the style of the text adventure? And B, do you think that their text adventure was well designed in terms of it being fun and also keeping with the funny and kind of like the almost surreal theme too?
Yeah, you know, yeah, I agree.
So two questions of the day.
Two questions.
Bonus question.
There you go. Well, we'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching, everybody.
Bye, guys.